dairy products, today even drinking yogurt. How many different products can you have? Dairy is very special. You have special requirements from the environment. You need material which is robust and is a definitely change in between dairy products and in between dry products. Therefore, our product portfolio is modular. Driven by the environment the checkweigher gets installed in and driven by the requirements our customer is giving us, we fulfill and serve either one. Wipe down as well as wash down. Maybe in combination with a metal detector. Maybe for larger and heavy products. Or for high throughputs and difficult contents, like liquids. But they're not only in small bottles, they could be also in combi blocks, in tetra packs, in larger sizes. So here we have an example, which is indicating how we're using an HCA, which is normally used for high speed, in this environment with special options we have connected to this machinery. With cycle conveyors, we're taking over the products. After that, we're weighing those products and those out of tolerance getting safely rejected. Further down, we're using the same side pressing conveyors for a stable and safe product transfer to the downstreaming machinery. This HCA checkweigher is running at a speed of 400 pieces per minute. Depending on the location and the place where a checkweigher is installed, you may have different cleaning requirements. For example, you want to clean your conveyors quite intensively, but you're unable to do so with water because the environment does not accept. For this, we have our VA series. You dismantle the conveyors, take them off, and the motor drive stays at the checkweigher. So you can take away the metal bed of the conveyor and clean this one intensively in a different area with water and whatever you want. Once in the opposite, you have an area where you have a very high requirement for washing down the machinery with detergents, with high pressure water, then you would better use a washdown machinery called WD. The following video is telling you a little bit what you already know. We made an example showing how we would clean this washdown machinery. High pressure cleaning, using water and the environment. Switching the machine into the cleaning mode will document and record the time where you have set the machinery in a mode where it's impossible to use it, so it's off production. You're documenting that, and additionally, we have certain presets which allow that the belts turning in opposite direction as usual at a lower speed. That is going to ease your cleaning process. The length of the products in relation with the speed determine the length of the weighing conveyor. The length of the weighing conveyor determines the gap which we would need from leading edge to leading edge of the products or in between the products, because we only can have one product at a time on the weighing conveyor. So this is one of the points where we have to look into that, how your production process is organized. So typically, a checkweigher has an infeed, a weighing, and an outfeed conveyor. And we need products in a distance leading edge to leading edge with the same length as the weighing conveyor is. The ideal situation is then when products feed it to the checkweigher with the distance required by the weighing conveyor. It's also quite easy when products coming directly together with no gap in between. So we can generate the required gap easily. It becomes more complex when we have irregular distance in between products and when products going to touch. it becomes very demanding when we have stable distance and products touching, because here we would need the most modification. In order to generate the situation which we want to have, we would normally use different options out of our portfolio. One could be using additional conveyors. So with an additional conveyor, we can slow down products to a well-defined situation and then accelerate the products again to generate the gap which we would need. That would help to have a situation which is stable for product handling and stable for the speed. The same attention as the infeed situation needs the outfeed situation. Imagine you're running high speed and you want to reject an incorrect product. So you must also consider that when you have activated, for example, the air nozzle, the product still will travel a certain distance before going off the conveyor. Overall, you're serving customers, and those customers have also their requirements which you have to fulfill. Take, for example, the so-called supermarket specification. We have all the configuration, options, parts, and whatever you want, whatever you need to fulfill them in our portfolio. So nothing to be afraid of. Then on the other side, you may also want to see what is ongoing in your production. You maybe would like to use the checkware, which is checking 100% of your products, as a source for your data, where you can have situations where you see what is going on. So here we would using ComScale, which you're connecting to your ESA network, and you can get information directly, almost in real time, to see what is ongoing and where you get interesting statistics per lane or per product. For us, product handling is key. Our weighing process is perfect. We like dairy.